Hello, and welcome to the first episode in our video series on smart bidding. My name is Ben Carl, and I'm a developer relations engineer on the Google Ads API. In today's episode, I'll provide an overview of smart bidding and go into the basics on how to set up a smart bidding strategy. Let's get started. If you're here, chances are you already know about smart bidding. But in case you don't, smart bidding is a set of automated bidding strategies like maximize conversions or maximize conversion value that use machine learning to optimize for conversions or conversion value and sets precise bids at each and every auction. In general, automated bidding strategies are important because they enable you to optimize your bidding much more efficiently than if you manage them manually. Some campaign types, like Performance Max, can only use smart bidding strategies. Smart bidding also evaluates a wide range of contextual signals available at auction time, like a user's device, location, browser, and more, and can also recognize and adjust for meaningful interactions between billions of combinations of signals that can impact your conversion rates. If you'd like to learn more about bidding in general, take a look at our bidding guide. I've included a link in the description of this video. As I mentioned earlier, smart bidding is designed to optimize for conversion or conversion value. In order to use smart bidding, your account must have conversion tracking enabled. If you only report conversion metrics, that's okay, but it's better to also report conversion value so that you can optimize towards different values for each conversion action. Once you are reporting meaningful conversion values, you can use a value-based bidding strategy like maximize conversion value with a target return on ad spend, or ROAS. Next, we'll take a look at an example of how to create a conversion action. Enabling conversion tracking requires different steps depending on the type of conversion you're interested in. For the sake of simplicity, I'll focus on click conversions. For details on setting up other types of conversion actions, see our conversion guide, which is linked in the description. Here's an example of a simple conversion action that will enable click conversion tracking. Note that we've set the value settings field, which means that this action will track conversion value, which is preferred when using smart bidding. Tracking individual conversions will vary depending on the conversion action type you're using. See our conversion guide for details on that. Now that you have a conversion action enabled, you can create a smart bidding strategy to really take your optimizations to the next level. You can create a smart bidding strategy for a single campaign, this is called a standard strategy, or for multiple campaigns, which is called a portfolio strategy. Let's take a look at a portfolio strategy. Here's an example of a smart bidding strategy. Notice that we've set the maximize conversions value dot target ROAS field, which means the campaign will focus on getting as much conversion value as possible at the specified return on ad spend. Once the strategy is created, we'll set its resource name to the bidding strategy field on a campaign object in an update or create operation. Note that this is only necessary for a portfolio strategy. Setting a standard strategy is done differently. Now the campaign that's using this bidding strategy is set up to use smart bidding and will optimize its bid amounts to maximize your conversion value at your return on ad spend goal. To retrieve metrics for your portfolio smart bidding strategy, use the bidding strategy resource. There, you can filter for the individual bidding strategy created above and see how smart bidding is helping your campaign perform. Here's an example of a query that will show you the daily value of all conversions and the daily cost of ad interactions over the past 7 days. Assuming smart bidding is doing its job and best practices are followed, you would expect the value of conversions to increase compared to historical conversion data when smart bidding was not used. Keep in mind that when you're evaluating historical performance, you should exclude the most recent period of conversion delay. Conversion delay refers to the time period when people click an ad and when they perform a specific conversion action, for example, with install, purchase, add to cart, etc. Because Google Ads reports conversions by query date, you may not always see the most updated conversion numbers. They can sometimes cause CPA to look inflated or ROAS to look deflated. See the linked article in the description for more details. Thank you for joining me for the first episode of our Smart Bidding video series. I'll see you next time when we'll go into more detail on some of the bidding strategy types I mentioned earlier. If you have any questions, I've linked to our documentation homepage as well as our support forum in the description. Thank you.